The RESTful API supports results filtering using the filter query parameter. This is one of the most powerful features of the new API. It allows for extremely granular selection of resources based upon the fields in the response. The value supplied to the filter parameter is a list of field predicates using the API's filter grammar. For example, a getAgainstAPI/V2Users global collection will return the full list of all users. In the example shown, two users are currently defined in the address manager, so the response count is two and both user resources are in this collection. But adding a filter string will instruct the API to filter the user resource to only show where the name equals the string API user, as the username is a unique resource. Only a single user which matches that is now returned. The next example uses the API V2Users collection again. This time we want to see the users who do not have access to the gateway product. Access to the gateway product is controlled by the user-defined field called BlueCat Gateway, which is assigned to users. So if that UDF is null, it means the user doesn't have access. So this can be achieved with a getAgainstAPI V2Users with a filter set to user-defined fields.BlueCatGateway equals null. And notice how the API call uses the fields parameter to only show the ID name, email, and gateway UDF in the response as well. Now, if the reverse is desired, e.g. show all the users who have access to a BlueCat gateway group, the not equal operator can be used instead. This time, only the users who have a value defined in the UDF will be shown, e.g. those that have access to a gateway permission group. There is an extensive set of supported field operators which can be used individually or combined together with AND/OR logic to create powerful filter expressions. The first two demonstrations use the EQ equals operator and the NOT equals operator NE on standard fields and then on a user-defined field. The following examples will utilize AND/OR logic to combine these filter predicates together. The following demos will utilize AND/OR logic combining filter predicates. This will meet a use case of trying to find the RFC19 network used in the Toronto location. The first API call is a simple get API V2 networks to see the collection of networks over all configurations. In this address manager, there are thousands of networks, hence pagination has occurred, so filtering can help us to narrow this down. The next API call builds on the first to limit the data being returned to only the specific fields needed to meet the use case. It makes the output more readable for a human, but it doesn't help with the automatic selection of the correct network address space. The required network that needs to be found is 192.168.1.0/24. This can be achieved with a simple change to the API to include a filter for the range where it equals that address space. This limits the number of networks just to return two in the response. As the demo is specifically looking for the network in the Toronto office, another filter is needed for location.name. If we combine these two filters together with a logical AND, it becomes filter equals range equals 192.168.1.0/24 and location.name equals Toronto. The response is a single network in the Toronto address space of 192.168.1.0/24. So in this demo, by combining two filter predicates together with an AND operation, we have successfully found the Toronto RFC 1918 network address space out of thousands of networks on this address manager. We now have an automated way of directly accessing this resource using the self-link. In the next demonstration, the use case is to show update and delete transactions that have occurred on the address manager in the last hour. There is a global resource collection for transactions on the address manager at the URI API V2 transactions. The RESTful API uses ISO 8601 formatted date time strings. To select between two time periods, for example an hours period, the creation date time field greater or equal to the start date time string is one predicate, and less than or equal to the end date time string predicate is used. And there is an equals predicate for the transaction of type delete. But in this specific use case, it was also to show the update transactions too. And it's now important to note that when combining AND or predicate, the AND logic has a higher order precedence. If the order of the predicates is as shown, with the date, time, AND operations first in the ordering, and the OR operations second, then the API will return correctly. But if you reverse this ordering, a different response is seen. Instead of just two operations returned, we now see 13 operations returned. The correct way to write this API call would be to add parentheses around the OR operations if they're in the first order. The parenthesis around the two ors actually then makes this condition and this condition and this condition and this condition, and correctly returns the correct response. Demo 13 has shown how the filters option within the V2 RESTful API can provide a powerful way to select specific resources from resource collections. Demo 13 also showed how the API supports an extensive set of operators which can be used with the filter parameter upon fields. And Demo 13 also showed how the filter predicates can be combined with AND/OR logic.